Hey, what's up, everybody? Well, I got into guitars through repairing guitars, right? And you're probably thinking right now, well, I'm not looking at a guitar, I'm looking at a banjo. True, very true. The act of me repairing guitars actually goes all the way back to high school. Used to repair all, you know, figure it out, repair my friend's guitars, you know. We were kids, we didn't have money, right? So through the years, I've taken on work to do repairs, setups, this, that, and whatever. So I have a guy I work with, he purchased a banjo. And it's for a friend of his, and he wants me to check it out. He says, you know, do what you gotta do. Give it back to me. I'm gonna give it to my buddy, and he's gonna have some fun with it. The guy's never played before. He wants to learn. So he brings me this. It's a Kimberly banjo. It seems to be, I really don't know anything about banjos, all right? It seems to be a pretty good banjo. I like it. I like the wood they used on it. And the back, look, it's got binding all the way around it. The back's got like that classic burst, right? This is nice, right? It's got the fade even on the neck. See how it's light in the center and it's dark on the outside. I mean, that's like something I like doing the guitars I build, right? It's a banjo. Okay, we'll stay there. It's a 5-string banjo is what it is. So, I'm checking it out for the customer. See what it needs to be done. Obviously, new strings. So, we ordered a 3-pack of D'Addario banjo strings. Hopefully I'll use one and I'll be able to give him 2 packs to go with. This way he's got extra strings because he said he's a beginner. I went with the light strings. I know nothing about banjos, but I'm assuming it's going to be okay. And here's Puma. She likes to participate in all my videos. The problem is we don't want cats around our instruments, Puma. So you have to come say hi and just hang out there. I don't know if the customer's gonna like my cat hanging out with their. She said, if he's got a problem, tell him to come see me. All right, well, you're in like Flint, boom. So anyway, first things first, checking it out. These are new strings. I haven't messed with the tuning or anything like that. I take that out, I check to see how straight it is, what kind of relief we have. Everything's looking pretty good on it, right? All right, let me get down to business here. I'm going to take off the resonator from the back. There's only 4 screws that hold it on. I'll do that real quick. I need to take the back off. Not only to check there's some surface cracks there on the back, so I want to see if they go all the way through. Not only to check that, but you know, it's part of the banjo setup is going to be checking all the nuts that go around the banjo. There's I don't know exactly how many there are, to be honest with you. So what it does is when you tighten those down, it stretches that white. You see that white material, it stretches that out over the banjo. Like I said, I'm not like a professional banjo man here, but I mean, I know enough and I can get it going and I can do what he needs to do and make it very simple process for him so his buddy can get his new banjo. I'm gonna go ahead and tighten up all the screws in here. There's 1 million screws on the inside. Then on the outside of it, there's all those nuts which tighten down that white part, right? And what you're looking at in the middle of the banjo, that rod, that adjusts the angle of the neck. Inside the neck, there's another rod, call it the truss rod, and that'll it'll give you relief of the neck, meaning you can like bow the neck, make it a U shape if needed. And there's cases where you might need that. I think more importantly though, the angle of the neck so you can get the right string height. And that's what I'll be doing, is adjusting that bar. Everything's so loose and the string height was so high, I'm pretty sure I'll just have to tighten that bar down. I'll have to pull the neck back. This way I'll be able to lower the strings. And see, I flipped this puppy over. I'm gonna take these strings off and clean it up a little bit. I mean, that's what this really needs. It's been sitting for a while. Typically, my go-to is going to be the tung oil, as you see. Boiled linseed oil too is a really, really good option for the wood. It'll rejuvenate the dry wood. Now, is there a difference between them both? Nah. The price. Boiled linseed oil is going to be a lot cheaper than tung oil. I don't really use that much per, so I just buy one thing of tung oil. But if you're doing a lot, you probably want to go to the boiled linseed oil. It's just a preference thing. Honestly, there is no difference between them. Since it's been sitting a while, it has something called fret sprout. I'm going to take this block here and I'm going to give it a radius on the edge because I'm not happy with what, or I'm going to give it a chamfer because I'm not happy with it how it is. And then I'm also going to file the end. Now, the fret sprout is the very end of the frets that are poking through the wood because the wood's contracted, but the metal didn't contract. It just stayed the same. Therefore, you have metal out the ends now. So you'll see here, I'm going to take the little file and I'm just going to file down the ends. Sometimes I got to get more involved. These aren't too bad. I can just go doot, 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 and that feels good. It's great. Not a lot of work. And I'll just go right up this neck and do that. It's now time to put the strings on. I have the D'Addario Lite. And if you use the D'Addario, here is a code. Try and use it. Player Circle. First come, first serve. All right, we got the banjo here. I'm gonna adjust the action on it. I can hear myself. I'm gonna adjust the action on it. The bridge actually needs to be adjusted. It's a little too high. All right, and then we're gonna tune it and we're gonna hand it over. I charged $55 for this setup, and that included three packs of strings. That was my charge because it's not even a full hour's worth of work. Usually it's $65 an hour, which from what I understand, people are telling me that's cheap. So we didn't go too crazy on this thing, but we set it up so he's all ready to play. That's the whole goal. So let me go ahead, take care of the string height, and then see what this thing sounds like. I don't know how to play it, but we can try. All right, so pretty much the action was extremely high, and we now lowered it down to about an eighth of an inch. The bridge was in the wrong spot. It's supposed to be equal lengths from the nut to the 12th fret. It should be the same exact from here to here, from the 12th fret to the bridge. So the bridge was too far back towards the tail. The tail piece wasn't on there right. And the bridge was too high. It also had a little tilt forward. I was just thinking spin it around so it tilts back. If anything, I want it to tilt back, right? That's about it. Now I'm gonna put the resonator back on the back. I'm gonna tune it up and we're gonna hand it over. Right back. Any finger picks or anything. The banjo's done. I really don't know anything on the banjo. I was playing around with it. I taught myself a couple little finger pick style. Well, that's all she wrote for Mr. Banjo. enough for today. We're going to go ahead and hand this on over to good old Gary. Gary's going to take it up to his buddy in New York, and he's going to have some good old banjo time. That's all for today, folks. Joe Kaiser, over and out. I will see you guys on the next video. I promise. Have a good day. Have a good night. Have a good whatever it is, wherever you're at. And I'll see you guys on the next video. Banjo, no. We don't want no stinking banjos. No. All right, cut.